Hello. So like I mentioned in the previous video, when we discussed forensic analysis, I talked about a free forensic analysis tool. Actually, specifically, this is a free non-volatile forensic analysis tool, right? It can only be used to perform non-volatile storage device inspections, okay? So this cannot be used to inspect main memories or RAM memories. Okay, the whole idea here is to very briefly show you how such a tool can be used, okay? Although this is a sort of tutorial, you do not need to do this. Obviously, unless you do want to do this, you have the steps here, right? So basically, the whole point of this tutorial is to show you how to install Autopsy in Kali Linux, how you can create a new project in Autopsy, and then find a specific file, in this case, the hello.txt file, okay? So like I said, this the goal here is not to ask you to actually do this. I just want you to have an idea of how the application works. So, but you do, if you do want to do it, I'm assuming that you have Kali Linux, so you just need to install sleuthkit and Autopsy, right? And then you are going to create a new project. But before you, in order to create a new project, you need to access Autopsy. So like I said, Autopsy has a web interface. So you simply need to open your browser and type localhost :9999. That's the port that Autopsy listens to. So 9999/autopsy. That's actually the port that sleuthkit is listening to. And then /autopsy to access Autopsy. So here you can see the welcome page, the Autopsy forensic browser welcome page, right? Like I said before, Autopsy is part of the sleuthkit project. And here you can determine what you want to do. Well, if you do have an open case already, you can click here on open case. It will show you the cases that it sees, and you can select the one that you already have. I'm assuming that's not the case, so you want to click on new case. And observe here that since this is a forensic analysis project, right? In many situations, this project may be associated with a court case. So you want to name this case, not only the project, but actually the case. So this tool can be used in order to generate evidence to be used in court. Obviously, you need to be careful with how you are collecting and handling the source of evidence, okay? So you can name it, you can give a description, you can determine the investigators that are part of this case, right? And then you click on new case. Once you've done that, what you want to do is to add the image file. Now, here's where you need to understand what you're doing, okay? As you can see, so Autopsy cannot directly read a hard drive, for example. So you gotta tell it the file that actually has the evidence or the data that you want to inspect. Now, you may ask yourself, well, but I don't have a file, or it's not just one specific file that I want to investigate, I want to inspect. Yes, that is correct. But remember, the first thing that you need to do is to image the hard drive that you are going to inspect, or the flash drive that you're going to inspect. And yes, you can image that original source to another destination, but such as another hard drive, right? But when you do that imaging, that is actually going to be sent as a file, okay? So you need to make sure that you are imaging that source into a file. And here you are going to identify, to point out to that file. What I'm saying is, this is just one example, okay? This is publicly available in Sam's class. So if you wanna try it, you can download this file here. Basically, the F200.E01 file is the image of a hard drive or a flash drive, okay? Although it's a flash drive or hard drive, it's identified here as a file. So you click on Add Image File, you point to that file, there it is. And then you need to define what type of image this is. Is this the image of an entire disk or the image of just a single partition? So you select it here, then you click Next, and this is what you are going to see. Since you defined it as disk, it will ask you what you want to analyze. Do you want to analyze the disk as a raw disk, a raw sequence of data, or do you want to analyze it as a C drive? That is because Autopsy was able to identify that, well, you said that this is an entire disk, but I can see that this disk actually has a partition. That partition is called C, the C drive, which also means that this is a Windows operating system, and obviously this is confirmed by the file system type here, NTFS. So basically, you can determine what kind of inspection you want to do. You want to inspect a raw source of data, or you want to inspect it as a container of files. Right, and obviously it's going to be easier to do this way as a container of files, because then you can search for file names instead of simple file content. So you select the C drive and you click on Analyze. From once it opens the Analyze screen, you can simply search for file names, search any way you want. You can search for file names, you can search for data, such as strings contained in a file, so you can basically determine the type of search that you are going to conduct, okay? So, also, the Autopsy also has image integrity feature, right? File activity timelines, hash databases. So, in order to perform evidence or data authentication, right? Image integrity to conduct MD5 checksum, for example, right? You want to search for those times that I mentioned in the previous video, such as creation time, modification time, and access time. So, basically, all of the features that you need in order to conduct non-volatile digital analysis is provided to you by the Autopsy tool. So I hope you enjoyed this tool, and if you do get the chance, just give it a try. Thank you.